The last NFL video, we talked about the Carolina Panthers and whether it would be smarter to take the under or be risky and take the over. Now we're talking about the same thing, but with the New Orleans Saints. Welcome back to The Sports Geek. I'm Taylor Brennan. Make sure you hit that subscribe button and notification bell so you never miss an episode. So with the New Orleans Saints, we have said goodbye to Drew Brees and hello to maybe Jameis Winston or maybe Taysom Hill. The Saints have shown that they can win without Brees, but it is still a bump in the road the Saints have to overcome. According to BetOnline, they are at 9.5 win projection. So let's talk about how they could reach their over or why it might be wise to stay with the under. So where are the Saints at as we near the start of the season? Sean Payton is going into his 16th year in the league. The offense is stacked with Alvin Kamara, Ty Montgomery, and Michael Thomas, in addition to a powerhouse offensive line. When it comes to defense, yes, they have lost some key players, but they still have Marshawn Lattimore, Marcus Williams, C.J. Gardner-Johnson, Demario Davis, and Cameron Jordan. But we all know that the QB dilemma is what a lot is riding on. Taysom Hill is a great running quarterback, but lacks with his passing technique. Jameis Winston is the turnover king, but has put up impressive numbers with over 30 touchdowns and 5,000 yards. So it really could go either way with who they decide to bench and who they decide to start. I think Hill should start because he is a run-first quarterback who, when forced, can throw. And with Michael Thomas and strong running backs, in addition to the line I talked about earlier, I can see the Saints going far. We can't sleep on the defense either with powerhouse players like PJ Williams, Patrick Robinson, and Malcolm Jenkins. So what is New Orleans lacking? When you look at history, the Saints prior to Drew Brees were lower in the pack. They have picked up speed with QBs taking over while Brees was injured, like Teddy Bridgewater. In addition, besides Thomas, they don't have a deep roster of wide receivers. And finally, on defense, they have players like Jordan and Davis who are getting into their final years in the league. So there are a lot of question marks when it comes to obstacles the Saints have to overcome. Let's look ahead to the season. They face 10 of 17 games against playoff caliber teams. Looking at their schedule, I'm calling 8-9, which is a game and a half under. And if the stars align and they make the right decision on the QB, they can win as many as 14, which is above the 9.5 projection. So let's break it down for the over-under. If they start the wrong QB, expect the under. And if they start the right QB and the rest falls in place, maybe we can beat the over. Let me know in the comments if you are taking the over, the under, or neither for the 2021 New Orleans Saints team. For The Sports Geek, I'm Taylor Brennan, and I'll see you next time.